Hey, what's up everybody? In this video, I'm gonna look at two of my favorite military stocks, Huntington Ingalls Industries and L3Harris Technologies. It seems to me that the entire defense industry is a little beaten down right now in terms of stock price, so I thought it was a good time to see if there's any good deals there. I'm gonna analyze both companies' balance sheets, look at their profitability, and use a discounted cash flow technique, and ultimately try and figure out which one is a better deal. If you're new to the channel, my name is Dan. I'm a business school professor, very interested in the stock market. I do a lot of investment videos on this channel. So if you like that kind of thing, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on more videos. All right, let's jump into it. All right, let's talk about Huntington Ingalls Industries first. The way they make their money is primarily through shipbuilding. You can see they've got the Newport News segment of their business in the Ingalls segment. Both of those are shipbuilding segments, just located in different places. They may as well be lumped together. They also have sprung up a new technical solutions segment. Currently, you can see that doesn't account for a large portion of their revenues. I also color coded it by the type of customer. The technical solutions segment is the only one where you have non-US government customers. But you can see pretty much the company relies over 95% on the U.S. government. When we look at L3Harris, the picture is a little bit different. 73% of their sales come from the U.S. government, and 27% come from other sources. So L3Harris has a little more customer diversification. They also have better diversification in terms of their segments. You've got aviation systems, communication systems, space and airborne systems, and integrated mission systems. So they're operating a variety of areas compared to HII, where they just purely build ships. Now, both companies are pretty heavily concentrated. They rely heavily on the U.S. government as a major customer. Now, academic research has shown that, okay, when you have a major customer, you're very reliant on them. That increases your risk. However, if that major customer is the US government, on average, it really increases the company's efficiency and their profitability. The reason for this is that they have very reliable demand every year, and they're able to tailor their operations to be much more efficient compared to other firms with more volatile demand. Let's compare the two firms' balance sheets. One thing that strikes me right away is Huntington's liabilities-to-asset ratio is significantly higher than L3Harris's. That's something we're going to have to consider when we value those cash flows. The Huntington company here clearly is riskier, and they're going to have a higher discount rate. Both companies maintain pretty snug liquidity ratios, with the current ratios both coming in close to 1.3 there, and the quick ratio is pretty close to 1.2. They're all above one, and that's good enough for me. I'm not too concerned about that. As far as their interest expense becoming a threat to their survival, neither company is really in the danger zone, with interest coverage ratios of 9 and 9.85 respectively. I'd like to see them higher, but again, with those reliable streams of income coming from the US government, they tend to like to take on more leverage. And I guess that's okay. L3Harris is a bit more long-term asset intensive there, with about 82% of their assets being long-term. But overall, L3Harris has the better balance sheet. Okay, so I'm going to compare the profitability of these two companies using a DuPont analysis. If you don't know anything about DuPont analysis, check out my video in the description below. But essentially, we're just going to compare their return on equity, or ROE, and the three components of ROE. So here for Huntington, they have by far the superior return on equity. It's fairly inconsistent, but it's always above 30% pretty much. Very high, very nice to see. L3Harris doesn't have a bad ROE, but it's far too volatile, you know, coming in at close to 50% there, and then most recently dropping to 7.2%. Very disappointing to see that. So what accounts for these differences? Well, you know, Huntington clearly has, you know, net income margin of anywhere from 6 to 10% or so. That means for every dollar of sales they have, the profit they're able to generate is between 6 and 10 cents. L3Harris is clearly the winner there. They have margins anywhere from, you know, 7 to all the way up to 14. That's much better. But L3Harris has very poor asset turnover. So for every dollar of assets in place, they only generated 63 cents of sales last year. Compare that to Huntington, and they're always able to generate more sales than they have assets in place, much more efficient. So overall, the two companies have actually not that dissimilar return on assets, but the big difference, of course, is that equity multiplier. So for L3Harris, they just don't have as much leverage in the most recent year, which really knocks down their return on equity. But overall, Huntington is a superior profitability company. Even if you just take the product of net income margin and asset turnover, you're going to get a higher number there for Huntington than you are for L3Harris. And the leverage differences only amplify that difference. They're not the sole cause of it. So again, Huntington is the winner for profitability. This headline here is one of the reasons I'm so interested in military stocks going forward. Historically, the U.S. has always started new wars for pretty much every administration, except the most recent one. We actually had a very peaceful 4 years there. And so going forward, you know, you look at their valuations, to me, things are only going to get better. We're going to have some more conflicts, most likely. And I'm a little optimistic on military stocks. Okay, so before we do a deep dive, we'll just have a quick look at Huntington Ingalls Industries here. As you can see, the stock price has not done well over the past year. Is this company headed for decline, or is this a great time to jump in and get a bargain? I hope to find out. They're trading at just about 11 times next period's earnings. So even if the earnings never grow, you know, it's a pretty darn good deal. The dividend yield's about 2.66%, and you got about close to a $7 billion company. Looks pretty attractive. Compare that to L3Harris. Their stock prices also suffered during the last year, but not nearly as much, down just about 11.5%. They're yielding just 1.8%, and they're trading at about 16.3 times next period's earnings. They are a little bit safer there in terms of size. You got a $39 billion company there. Here are some analyst forecasts for Huntington. It's very interesting here. One of the reasons they're trading at just 11 times earnings is that their earnings per share are actually expected to decrease by about 34% going into December 2021. After that, analysts are expecting that their earnings are going to then increase all the way to $13.69, and then another increase there to $17.68. So a very interesting path for their earnings. Overall, you are going to see earnings growth there if you're a long-term investor, but there will be some kind of shock there in the upcoming year. At least that's what they're expecting at this point in time. When I look at L3Harris Technologies, they don't have any sort of road bumps there. They've got smooth expected growth from anywhere from, it looks like, 11.74 to 14.5% there. Pretty steady, and then leveling off in about 5 years. All right, guys, so after analyzing both companies, I really like them both. And what it's going to come down to is the price we're paying compared to the cash flows we're going to receive. And to estimate that, I'm going to use a free cash flow to equity model. To make the model work, we're going to have several assumptions. Number one, we have to assume a discount rate. I'm going to show you the results with a variety of discount rates. You can make your own judgment. But in my opinion, HII has a worse balance sheet. They look riskier based on the volatility of those analyst forecasts. I'm generally going to assume they need a higher discount rate compared to L3Harris. The other variable is how much are these companies going to be able to grow their free cash flows at over the next 5 years. I'm going to rely on the analyst forecast data available to make those estimates, and I will show you how those estimates change the value of the company. So I'll show you the results using a variety of growth rates. After 5 years, I have to assume some kind of perpetual growth rate in free cash flows. I'll just assume about 1.5%, just saying they can keep up with inflation after that. And so let's plug the numbers in and see what we get. Alright guys, so here's a valuation matrix. Every cell is the value of Huntington, assuming a given discount rate, and assuming a given growth rate in the free cash flow to equity over the next 5 years. After 5 years, we're going to assume they can just keep growing at 1.5% per year. You've noticed I have plugged in pretty pessimistic growth rates because, again, they're expecting that sort of bumpy path where they lose a lot of earnings in 2021 and slowly regain them. And so I'm looking at an average of probably 0% growth over the next 5 years, maybe even negative. I've been a little pessimistic, saying about -4, -2 there, the most optimistic case being 2% growth. So which row is most likely? For me, I would say use one of these two rows here. I think 7 or 8% discount rate is fair. So I think probably to be a little conservative, you know, maybe this cell right here is the most likely one for me. I'm a pretty conservative estimator. That would still be a good deal compared to the share price today. And to get a better sense of that, you can look at the matrix below here. And you can see under most assumptions, it's a pretty good deal where I've color-coded it green there. Only in the most pessimistic scenarios there with the high discount rate, very low growth rate, does it become a bad deal. And even then, it's only overvalued by 19% at worst there. In the best case scenario, it's undervalued by about 87%. So overall, HII looks like a great deal right now. Let's look at L3 Harris Technologies. You notice for their valuation matrix, I have much more optimistic free cash flow to equity growth rates, as that's what analysts are expecting for this company. I do put a lot of faith in those analyst estimates for this type of industry. A lot of their contracts are pretty much set in stone. They kind of know where they're headed for the next couple of years. If anything, you know, these defense stocks, they have room for potential improvement. They don't have much room for disappointment. And the reason I say that is you never know when there'll be an all-out conflict that you don't expect, which leads to more military spending. But in any case, this company is a little safer, so I think you're going to be looking at one of these two rows here, a lower discount rate. And given their current share price, that means it's a good deal no matter what. Another way of interpreting this whole matrix is to say that, look, I want an 8% return. I think they're going to be growing at 11% per year. That puts me at this sell right here. I can't pay any more than $185.69. That's another way of looking at it. So anyhow, if you look at the matrix below, there's more good outcomes than bad here. And the bad ones are all pretty much in that high discount rate row there, which I think is too high of a discount rate to use for L3 Harris. So for me, this also looks like a good deal. So one last thing is insider activity. And for Huntington Industries here, you've got 18 insiders buying and one selling in the past 3 months. That is very favorable. You know, insiders usually already have a lot of their own shares. When they choose to buy more, that's usually a good thing. Now, the number of shares involved, you can see there again, you've got much more shares being bought compared to shares sold. And that's true in the last 12-month period as well. So overall, a pretty positive indication for Huntington. Let's compare that to L3 Harris. They've got more insider sales transactions than insider buys. Let's see how many shares are involved. And so yeah, for example, in the most recent 3 months, you have way more insider selling compared to buying, a slightly negative indicator about the future, but overall not overwhelmingly negative. You don't see all the insiders dumping. They might just need to cash out to get some money. All right, everyone, here are my final thoughts on these two military stocks. I really like both of them, to be honest. If you have to compare the two, L3 Harris is larger and has a safer balance sheet. That makes them safer, but Huntington has the better profitability, not 100% driven by leverage. They also just generally have better return on assets. As well, when you look at insider trading activity, Huntington is clearly showing indications that the insiders believe the stock is undervalued, and insiders generally know more. So overall, I think Huntington looks to be better. when we do the discounted cash flow analysis, even if we give Huntington a higher discount rate, they do appear to be more undervalued compared to L3 Harris. And so I'm leaning towards Huntington. That being said, L3 Harris also looks like a good deal, and I do like to diversify. So personally, I'm going to buy both. That's just my opinion. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Definitely leave that like. It really helps me. Thank you guys for watching.